Good morning, my dear students. In our previous video, we have covered the half part of the story, the amazing story of Kipchok Keno. You have learned that he was from Kenya. He was an athlete and he was very much determined. He has practiced running since his childhood. Means he used to run to his school, then used to come back for lunch at home, running again, used to go back to school and again at the back to home. So every day he used to run till he was in the school, and in this way he developed a running habit and he became an athlete. Now you have also seen that during one of his race he collapsed and he disqualified himself, but as he was determined to finish the race, he again got up and completed his race. Now let's see what happens next. Prior to running the 1000 meters, Kip had been told by a doctor not to run and that any strain to his body was at risk of causing him serious harm and in the extreme case could even lead to his death. So before running this 10,000 meter race, the doctors had told him not to give any strain to his body. Strain means make an unusually great efforts. So as you know that to run a race, it needs to put lot of efforts. And as he was an athlete, he had to put great efforts to win. But you know that he was suffering from the infection in his gallbladder, and so doctor advised him not to give strain on his body, otherwise it would harm him, even it would lead to his death. But that did not stop him from participating. 2 days after the 10,000 meters, the race he collapsed in, Kip ran in the 5,000 meters and won a silver medal, finishing just 1/5 of a second behind the gold medalist. So, but as I told you earlier, that Kip was much determined. He was mentally strong. So he participated in the race. He did not stop participating in the race, and you already know that what happened. He collapsed, but after that again he participated in the 5000 meters race, and in that race he won silver medal. He was just 1/5 second behind from the gold medalist, so there was very slight difference in both of them. By 1/5 of a second he was behind, and he achieved silver medal in 5000 meters race. On the top of that, he then ran another 1500 meters race and qualified for the final of the event. Then again he participated in 1500 meters race, and there also he was qualified for the final event. On the day of 1500 meters final, Kip, because of his ailment, wound up oversleeping. When his absence was noted, people thought that he had chosen not to race on medical grounds. So the day of 1500 meters final race came, and as he was suffering from the infection in gallbladder because of his ailment. Ailment means illness. Because of his illness, he woke up late, and the people noticed that Kip was not there. The people noticed his absence for the race. So they thought that he must have decided not to race because on the medical grounds. Medical grounds means because of his ailment. As you know, the doctor has suggested him not to give strain, right? So people thought that due to his ailment, he has decided not to run the race. Nevertheless, only an hour before the actual event, he hopped out of the bed and headed off to the games. But what happened? He did not give up. Before 1 hour of the race, he woke up from his sleep and he moved off to the games. On the route to the Olympic Stadium, the bus was stuck in traffic. Realizing that he was going to be late, Kip got off and ran the remaining 2 miles to the Olympic Stadium while carrying his equipment. Already he was late. He boarded the bus. Then due to traffic, the bus was not able to move ahead. So he got down from the bus and started running to reach the Olympic Stadium. So here before the race, he ran 2 miles to reach the Olympic Stadium, that too with all his equipments. He then registered with 20 minutes to spare, got himself ready and walked out onto the track and won a gold medal, outpacing the second place runner by an astonishing 20 meters, the longest distance anyone had ever won by in the event at that time. So then finally he reached the stadium and he registered himself 20 minutes before. After registering his name, he got ready for the race, and in this race he secured gold medal, outpacing the second place runner by an astonishing 20 meters. Outpacing means going faster than. So he was faster than the second runner by 20 meters. There was a distance between the two of 20 meters. The longest distance anyone had even won by in the event at that time. So this was the longest distance anyone had even won at that time. Means nobody had won by 20 meters. He was 20 meters ahead than the second runner. Not only this, the man he beat by such a huge margin, Jin Ryun, had not been defeated in the 1500 meters in 3 years. So now the second runner whom he has defeated, his name was Ryun, Jin Ryun, and in 3 years, in 1500 meters, nobody had defeated him. He was always the, for 3 years successively, he was the winner of 1500 meters. But this time, Kip, he defeated him. Also, Kip had not raced 5 times in that Olympics, while Ryun was completely fresh. So also Kip had not raced 5 times in that same Olympics when Ryun was very fresh, completely was very fresh, he was new to that game. On top of all that, Kip was unwell too. And apart from this, Kip was also unwell. He was suffering from severe ailment. In the end, Kip finished with an Olympic record time of 3 minutes, 349 seconds, the second fastest in history at that point. Another thing was that he finished the race with an Olympic record. He made an Olympic record time of 3 minutes 34.9 seconds. The second fastest in history at that point. So he was the second fastest to cover that distance within that time. That is 3 minutes 34.9 seconds. At the 1972 Olympics in Munich, West Germany, he won his second Olympic gold medal in 3000 meters steeplechase and also won a silver medal in the 1500 meters. So, in the year 1972, in the Olympics which were held in Munich in Germany, he won the second gold medal. In the 3000 meters steeplechase. Steeplechase means a race where the runner has to cross hurdles and water jumps. So 3000 meters steeple race, he got gold medal, and that was his second gold medal. Then again he achieved silver medal in 1500 meters. Kino retired from the track in 1973, a Kenyan hero, but there was much still to come from this remarkable man. Now, he retired from his game in the year 1973, the great hero of Kenya, Kipchoge Keino. He retired in the year 1973, but still there was more to come from him. He was such a remarkable personality, and still there was more to come from his side. Kip and his wife Phyllis purchased a farm in Eldoret, which they converted into an orphanage, the Kip Keino Children's Home. So Kip and his wife's name was Phyllis, both of them purchased one farm, and they converted that farm into an orphanage. They built an orphanage for the orphan children, and they named it as Kip Keino Children's Home. We started with two children, then it went to 6, then 10. Now it's up to 90. We give them shelter and love. So when Kipper and his wife started the orphanage, at that time in the beginning, they started with only two children. Then it became 6, then 10, and now they have 90 children in their orphanage. They give shelter to those orphans, and they also love them. They give not only shelter but also love. Many of these children who lived with us as orphans have gone to university. Some are doctors, and when you see them with their own families living well in society, I feel very happy, he says. So Kip says that the orphans who lived in his orphanage, they were given well education, and some of them have become doctors as well. Now these, so he says, then when he sees them living with their family happily in the society, he feels very happy. The Keino family realized a lifelong dream in 2000 with the creation of the Kip Keino School, funded by various donations. Almost 300 children attend the school. Then Kip and his family realized their lifelong dream. Their dream was to run a school, and in 2000 they started a school. Now this school was funded by various donations, and now almost 300 children go to this school, attend this school. So this was the story of a great hero from Kenya, that is Kipchoge Keino. because of his hard work, because of his determination, he is loved by all. So it is said that there are no secrets for success. So the only thing to get success is hard work. I hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.